Grande is at risk of running dry through Albuquerque. Water management officials are warning about what this could mean for local farmers and wildlife. News 13's Natalie Wattis is live along the river in Central with more details.
Kim, as you can see, I'm standing in an area that is normally underwater, but now it's mostly sandbar here. According to measurements from today, the water flow is about as weak as it's ever been over the past 50 years.
Given the drought conditions that we have the current water situation, that it's very likely that we're going to see drying on the Rio Grande through the Albuquerque area if we don't receive rain soon.
Jason Kasuga, the chief engineer for the Middle Rio Grande Conservancy District, says because of the weak snowpack and lack of rain, they can't release water from the reservoirs upstream like Cochiti. A couple other factors preventing a late summer water release are work on the dam at El Vado near Chama and obligations to Texas downstream under the water compact.
New Mexico has underdelivered in that agreement over the last couple of years, so we are actually in a debt status to Texas. And we ended 2021, I believe, approximately 127,000 acre feet in debt.
Elephant Butte Lake is only half as full as it was 3 months ago, and its water level dropping about 20 feet. And federal measurements taken today show the water level here in the area that I'm at are only about 2 feet high. Back to you.
Okay, thanks, Natalie. Now,
NASA recently released new photos that show the drastic water levels of Lake Mead, which have reached a historic low. Meteorologist Danielle Giuliano takes us through the images and the impact of this drought. Danielle?
Yeah, that is right, Mary. Lake Mead is the largest reservoir in the United States. It supplies water to millions of people across seven western states, tribal lands, and northern Mexico. These images provide an eye-opening illustration of the long-term drought that may be the worst in the western U.S. in 12 centuries. Only 10% of the water in Lake Mead comes from local precipitation and groundwater each year. The rest comes from snowmelt in the Colorado River Basin up in the Rocky Mountains, where 83% of the state is in drought. Back in June, the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation Water issued an emergency request to the Colorado River Basin states to reduce water usage over the next 18 months. On top of being a main source of water, Lake Mead is also placing recreation on restriction due to the extreme drop of water levels. The National Park Service has closed 6 of the 7 boat ramps. And you can find more information and detail on the drought impacting the western states on newsforjax.com.
Tonight, record high temperatures across the country are fueling wildfires in 15 states, the largest in Northern California, with smoke now visible from the International Space Station. The Oak Fire exploded over the weekend as it burned out of control through a bone-dry forest. Thousands of firefighters have battled the flames for 4 straight days. The fire has burned nearly 17,000 acres and is 10% contained. Thousands of homes and businesses in a mountain community near Yosemite National Park remain under evacuation orders. Smoke has spread hundreds of miles away, reaching Lake Tahoe, parts of Nevada, and the San Francisco Bay Area. We've got a lot of news to get to tonight, and CBS's Jonathan Vigliotti starts us off. Jonathan, good evening.
Major progress here on the front line is measured by the minute. And this evening, this fire continues to explode as it rips through dry vegetation. It's also incredibly unpredictable, even for firefighters.
Fire is into the trees all around the property.
This radio dispatch is just one example of what crews are up against as they continue to battle California's largest wildfire.
Just want to let you know there's going to be fire on the ground.
More than 2,500 firefighters are now on the lines, working around the clock in intense heat and on steep terrain to put down the so-called Oak Fire from both the ground and air.
The fact that this is the biggest fire in the state, we were able to access personnel from all over the state, and help us mitigate this fire.
The vegetation is bone dry. It doesn't take much to turn it into a fire like this. There has been a stroke of some luck. The wind has remained calm. It only takes a gust, though, to turn fire like this into a wall of flames.
The fire has already incinerated more than 16,000 acres, destroyed 7 structures, including homes. But that number is expected to rise.
It's just stuff, but it's still amazing to see what survived.
More than 6,000 people are under evacuation orders, like Steve and Andrea Ward, newlyweds who watched their home burst into flames on TV.
I see a home, and it's an inferno. And then an explosion goes off.
Years of drought across the western U.S. and high temperatures over recent days have fueled flames reaching 50 feet into the sky.
This is not normal. Now we have multiple big fires every year. It's terrifying. It's absolutely terrifying.
And while wind conditions have remained favorable, there is the threat of gusts picking up tonight, as well as dry lightning, which could ignite this tinderbox. Major.
Jonathan Vigliotti, thank you.
A lot of Hoosiers are trying to figure out what they saw in the sky overnight.
Some people heard a loud boom, others just saw really bright light. Viewers have been sharing all their videos with us, so keep sharing them. This is one of them, and it's a video from Franklin. The Ring camera captured that bright blue light moving through the sky. So what is it? Well, another viewer had the same question from Brown County, sharing this clip where the light is so bright that at times it kind of looks like daytime when it flickers. Now, Purdue astronomy professor Raphael Lang says the object is something known as a bolide. So that means a fireball, or as Lang calls it, quote, a shooting star on steroids. We have a little bit more info for you, some more videos right now. It's all posted at Fox59.com.